Now, in the next option, or next question, look at here. The correct structure of the compound based on the following characteristic spectral data. Okay, now take a look. You don't have to solve total NMR data. We just have to use the trick. And what is the trick for that? Look at here. What you have to do? Whenever such type of questions are asked, then what you have to do? First of all, take a look at the higher value. What is the higher value? 1736. 1736, that means it is for Easter. Remember, I have told you 17302 1760, it is the range for carbon stretching frequency of Easter. Okay, so it is Easter, and no doubt all the options are Easter, so don't be confused in that. Now you have to answer within a fraction of time. Then what will you do? Take a look at the delta value. 3.56, that means it is near to 3.6. And if 3 proton, that means CH3. 2 proton, that3 proton singlet, that means CH3 attached to oxygen, because delta value is 3.59, which is near to 3.6. So we can say that in our option, in our correct option, or in our answer, CH3 must be attached to the oxygen. Now, out of the four options, C and D has the methyl group attached to the oxygen. So, out of C and D, what is our correct answer? And A and D are definitely wrong. Understand? A and D are wrong. So, our correct answer is from C and D only. Now, we have to summarize. Now, there is no need to solve CMR also. Now, when we proceed further, when we consider C and D options, so in C and D, take a look at option D. In option D, there are two CH3. One, this terminal which is attached to CH2, and another is this CH3 which is attached to the oxygen. But in the NMR data, only one 3-proton, that means only one CH3 is given. Another CH3 is not given. After CH, 3-proton, 2-proton, 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 and 2-proton. That means only one CH3 must be present in our correct answer. And only one CH3 is present in C option, not in D option. So, directly you can get the answer, that is C is the correct one, regardless of the other information. Understand? So, what you have to do, you have to use your common sense. First of all, you have to use the characteristic delta value, that means CH3 and CH2. Okay, so here, wherever the delta value of CH3 or 3-proton, it is in the range of 3.6 to 3.9, that means such CH3 is attached to oxygen. So definitely, first of all, you have to look at the option in which CH3 attached to the oxygen. And then you have to come back again the information. So when we see 3-proton singlet for 3.59, then definitely C and D may be possible, A and D are wrong. And after that, what you have to see? You have to see how many CH3 in C and D. Indeed, there are two CH3, but in information only one CH3 is given, only one 3-protons are given. That means correct answer is C, not D. Okay. Now next one. A compound displays the following spectral data. The correct structure of the compound is. Okay, tell me, screen is visible to all of you or not? Screen is visible to all of you or not? Okay, now take a look. Here the next question. In the next question, in this question, look at here. Again, I am telling you, you have to use the trick. That means common sense. Look at here. What is the first value? IR. 1690. 1690, that means ketone. Okay. 1690 definitely out of the four options, option B, these are the two options, they are eastern, that means they are not possible. Then what will be the correct answer? Our correct answer is from A and C. Okay, A and C. So only from higher value we can neglect the two options B and D. That means our correct answer is from A and C. Now we will proceed. Now in our data, here three proton singlet. Okay, so look at here. How many signals here? Three proton, two CH3. One CH3 here. Again in this option, one CH3. Now what you have to do? You have to use this information. Which information? 6.9. Doublet J is equal to 8 Hz, 2 proton. And 7.8. Doublet J is equal to 8 Hz, 2 proton. Remember that. If aromatic region, that means delta value, if the delta value is extend from 6.5 to 8.5 with the following pattern. Doublet J is equal to 8 Hz, 2 proton. And doublet J is equal to 8 Hz, 2 proton. Then it is a para disubstituted benzene. Para disubstituted benzene. That means there are two groups attached to the benzene ring and they are para position with respect to each other. When this situation will come, when we have in the aromatic region 6.5 to 8.5 delta value here given, that means up to 6.5 to 8.5 and the signal is doublet for both and J is equal to 8 Hz. So wherever you see the options or wherever you see the informations having J is equal to 8 Hz for two proton with doublet signal, and these are in pair. Doublet J is equal to 8 Hz with two proton, and again doublet J is equal to 8 Hz with two proton. When this signal doublet J is equal to 8 Hz with two proton, it is in pair, then definitely it is a para disubstituted benzene ring. So here 6.9 and 7.8, these are the two delta value which is in the range of aromatic region 6.5 to 8.5, and it is in the pair doublet J is equal to 8 Hz, 2 proton. Doublet J is equal to 8 Hz, 2 proton. That means from this information it is clear that it is a para disubstituted system. And out of A and C, which is para disubstituted? A. So what is our correct answer? A. Do you got it? Understand? Okay. Now we will proceed for the next question. And take a look. Just use the simple tricks. It is very easy. Now after, next question. The organic compound that displays the following data. 1H NMR, 400 megahertz, the frequency of the instrument. Now tell me, look at here. If such questions are asked, then what do you have to do? Here number of protons are not given. Only singlet doublet is given and delta value is given. Now what you have to do? Here how many signals? 1, 2, 3. So what you have to do? You have to see 3 signals also. Now, look at here. Bromine here. Bromine is attached to the ring. And these are the two orthocarbon. They have two hydrogens. And both these hydrogens are ortho to bromine. That means their delta value is same. That means they give the same signal. That means one signal for ortho protons of bromine. Then we will consider, when we will consider meta position with respect to bromine, then again two protons, one here, another here. Okay, so what will happen here? They also give the same signal, that means one signal from the ortho protons, one signal from the meta. Okay, now here 3 CH3, that means 9 protons, they are attached to the common carbon, that means their environment is same. They also give single signal, that means in option A there are 3 signals, one for 2 hydrogen, one for 2 meta hydrogens and one for 3 CH3. And when we consider another option, for example here CH3, so So here CH3 one single. Then this one single for ortho hydrogen two. Then third single is for meta hydrogen. Then fourth single for 3CH3. Sorry, 2CH3. In this way, we will get four single for second option. Okay, when we consider third option, then it is a CH2, it gives one signal. Then two ortho hydrogen, they give one signal, two. Then two meta hydrogen, they give another signal, three. Then here CH3, it gives another signal, four. And this two CH3 gives the same signal, five. So third option gives five signal, second option gives four signal, and when we consider fourth option, so here these hydrogen gives one signal. All the aromatic hydrogen gives the different signal, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this 3CH3 gives one signal, 5. So that means second option gives 4 signal, third option gives 5 signal, and fourth option gives 4 signal again, but only one option gives 3 signal. So our correct answer is first. Now take a look, another one. The correct match of the circled proton in the column P with H1 NMR chemical shift delta ppm in column Q is, okay. Now tell me, how can you solve it? Now take a look. Whenever a ring system is given, what you have to do? You have to just find out whether the ring system is aromatic, non-aromatic, or anti-aromatic. Okay, aromatic, non-aromatic, or anti-aromatic. And if the protons inside the aromatic ring, then they are highly shielded by the diamagnetic anisotropic effect. And if they are outside the aromatic ring, then they are highly deshielded. I'm talking about aromatic system. So in aromatic system, if the hydrogen are inside the ring of aromatic ring, then they are shielded. And if they are outside the aromatic ring, then they are deshielded. If they are shielded, the delta value is very, very less. Sometimes it is in the minus. Okay. And if they are outside the aromatic ring, then they are highly deshielded. Their value is very high with respect to aromatic ring. Now, when we consider anti-aromatic ring, then situation is totally reverse. In anti-aromatic ring, the protons which are inside the ring, they are highly deshielded, and the protons which are outside the ring, they are highly shielded. Okay, so here paramagnetic anisotropic effect works in case of anti-aromatic ring. Now, what you have to remember, that whenever the ring system is aromatic, then inside protons are shielded and outside protons are deshielded. And when the ring system is anti-aromatic, then inside protons are deshielded. That means they have higher delta value. And outside protons are shielded, that means they have lower delta value. Understand this concept? Do you understand what you have to remember with respect to the delta value if the ring system is given and delta value of the protons are asked? So when may I ask the anybody? Look at here, what I am telling to you, if the aromatic ring is there, then inner protons are shielded and outer protons are deshielded. And in aromatic ring system, anti-aromatic ring system, situation is reversed. Inner protons are deshielded and outer protons are shielded. Screen is visible to all of you.
Yes.
Okay, now look at here. Which one is aromatic? Which one is anti-aromatic? Okay, now take a look. What you have to do? You have to remember that the aromatic compounds having 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Okay, 4n plus 2 pi electrons. So here, what you have to do in this ring system first? Just count the inner bond. This bond has a 2 electron. Then this has 2. Then this has 2. Then 2. Then 2. And this 2. So how many electrons in the first ring?
2 plus 2, 4 plus 2, 6 plus 8. Okay, then plus 2, 10, and this 2, 12. Okay, so if the number of pi electrons inside the ring are in the multiplication of 4, that means 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 28, that means such system is anti-aromatic. If number of electrons inside the rings are totally divided by 4, then such ring system is anti-aromatic. I am again repeating you, if the number of electrons, here triple bond is given, but you have to count only 2 electrons, not 4 electrons. So here 2 electrons from the double bond, 2 electrons from the triple bond, total 4, then again 2 electrons from double bond, 6, 2 electrons from triple bond, 8, 2 electrons from double bond, 10, and 2 electrons from again double bond, total 12, and 12 is divisible by 4. If it is divisible by 4, then it is anti-aromatic. And what I have told you, in case of anti-aromatic compound, inner protons are highly deshielded. Deshielded, that means their delta value is highest. Their delta value is highest. So this proton of compound first has the highest delta value out of these three. Which one has the highest? Which option has the highest delta value? B option, 16.4. So first has B. First is B, is in the option of 2 and 3. So definitely 1 and 4 are cancelled. So first and fourth are wrong options. Our correct answer is from second and third. Okay. So now we have to conclude whether second is true or third is true. Okay. Now consider the third system. In third system, again you have to count the number of electrons. 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 and plus 2. How many electrons? There are 7 double bonds. Okay, 7 double bonds, that means how many electrons? 14. 14 is not divisible by 4. Totally. Okay, so it is aromatic. Okay, it is a 14 plus 2 pi system. And what I have told you, if the system is aromatic and the protons are inside the ring, then now is it visible to you? Is it visible to you?
No, sir.
Is screen is visible to you?
No, sir.
Okay. Now is it visible to you? Now
yes,
is it visible?
Sir. Yes, sir.
I think it is visible. Okay. Now, look at here. Okay. Now, take a look. Here, when we consider third option, here proton is inside the ring. And this ring has the 14 electrons. 14 electrons, that means aromatic. Remember that. If the electron count is 2, then add 4 in the 2, it will become 6. Then again add 4, it will become 10. Then again add 4, then it will become what? It is 14. Okay. So here, third is aromatic. And in aromatic ring, if the protons are inside the ring, then they are highly shielded and they have the lowest delta value. In some cases, it is in minus also. So for third, what is the correct match? Definitely C. So out of second and third option, third has C in which option? Second. So which one is the correct answer? Second is the correct answer. Understand? Understand?
Yes, sir.
Understand this? You can reply me.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, take a look at another question from NMR spectroscopy. An organic compound having molecular formula
C15H14O exhibited the following 1H and C13 NMR spectral data.